Valve has released a new public beta of Counter-Strike Global Offensive. And in this public beta, there is a new version of DE Inferno. Let's have a look. First, we'll walk through the level and have a look at some interesting things. And then I'll leave you with some comparisons between the current version and the new beta version. And one thing up front, Valve is really making progress with community communications in this beta. They have already fixed several bugs and made other changes to the map. Good work. So, what is different? The visuals have changed a bit. They really outlined the Italian feeling alongside the increased visual appeal in general. Though the T-spawn is missing the belts. I like them. Almost all textures are completely redone. It looks a little clean in some places, but that drastically increased the visibility of enemy players. No chance they blend in with the background here. Some of the biggest changes in the world geometry are, for example, they brought back the second way out of the terrorist spawn that was there until Counter-Strike Global Offensive. In the old or current version of Counter-Strike Global Offensive's Inferno, you can still see the remains of the old route from Counter-Strike Source and earlier versions. In the new Inferno, they brought the second way out of the terrorist spawn back, but shortened the distance you have to walk, by that making the route more attractive than in the older versions. Back in 1.5, I almost never took the upper street. Another important change, they sealed off the dark room, lowered the fence at the elevated position at bombsite A, and made serious changes to bombsite A in general. They removed the roof that was there since the beginning, really lighting up the place and increasing visibility. Bombsite B also got a really nice visual upgrade. Besides that, some of the tricky spots are gone, no hiding here anymore, and the boxes have changed. I think they look a bit more like the ones from Nuke. Another thing that changed, the little ledges on the balcony are gone, though you can still make the jump. In addition to that, the windows have better visibility now. Right after the map was released in the beta, you were not able to throw grenades over rooftops, because Valve had decided to decrease the size of skyboxes to enhance the map's performance. Though this has been removed now. So no worries, you can still throw nades. Talking of nades, they also removed this little opening at the B spot. A thing that I was very interested in, did Valve clip all the stairs? Some older CSGO maps have very bumpy stairs, but in this new map everything is clipped, except for the sidewalk at the CT spawn. I tweeted about that to the CSGO developers, let's see if they respond or someone else has already pointed that out. Well, oh yeah, by the way, Escalation is now on Twitter, give it a look. And now I'm going to leave you with some comparison shots. Guess we have to update the map development history video for DE Inferno soon. So, if you have any thoughts on this remake, share them in the comment section down below. And also, which map do you think will be remade next? Will Dust2 be moved out of the active duty group and then get a remake? Or will we see one of the old maps redone for Global Offensive? Have a nice day, and as always, goodbye and guten Tag.